It is time to start your Zoom meeting. A few minutes before the time you set for your meeting, go back to your account in your browser. Click on Meetings, and if you have set a specific meeting with a name, it will appear on the screen. For this tutorial, though, we will use the Personal Meeting Room. Click on that. Then click the Start Meeting button on the upper right corner. If you have installed the Zoom client app, as I recommended, you'll see a small pop-up window inviting you to open zoom.us. So click on Open zoom.us. The Zoom window will open. The first thing you'll see is yourself if your camera is working. Now, let's familiarize ourselves with the commands. In the upper right corner, you have the icon to go to full screen, if you want. Try that. Now, let's look at the bottom menu, starting from left to right. First, you have a microphone icon. By clicking on the icon, you can mute and unmute your microphone. If you click on the up arrow to its right, you'll see a bunch of commands, where you can select a different microphone, select your speakers, test it, etc. On the bottom, you have audio settings. Clicking on it will open the settings, where you have other options like setting the volume of your mic or your speakers. Now let's go to the camera icon. By clicking on it, you can stop or start your camera. If you click on the arrow to its right, you'll see Choose a Virtual Background. We'll explore that feature on a separate video. You can use that when you're better acquainted with Zoom. You also have Video Settings. Click on it to open the Settings window. It has a lot of different options, but the only one I suggest you add to the default ones is Touch Up My Appearance. It will improve the quality of your camera slightly, but it will. Next, you have the invite icon. You can use that in case you want to invite someone to a meeting that is already in progress. I'll go over that in a future video. The next icon is Manage Participants. There, you can see how many people are participating in your call right now. Next, you have a green and very important icon, the Share icon. This is what you'll use if you want to share your screen. When you click on it, the first option on the left will be for you to share your desktop. That is the option you use if you want to share, let's say, a presentation or a document or whatever you want everybody to see. Just click on that and then the Share button. And that's it. You are now sharing. When you want to stop sharing, just look for the red button in the upper center of your screen and click on that. Any participant in your call can share their screen either, if they want to. If you click on the arrow to the right of the green icon, you'll see options like only one participant can share at a time or multiple participants can share simultaneously. You also have some advanced settings there that you can explore later. The next icon is for the chatbox. If you click on it while on full screen, it will open in the middle of your screen and you can move it. If you're not on full screen, it will show up on the right of your screen. This chatbox is very useful. There you can share messages with everyone or privately with one participant only. You can also use it to share files if you want. Finally, you have the record button. Use it if you want to record your session. When the session is over, the system will prompt you to save the video file on your computer. Last but not least, Zoom gives you two basic ways to view your call. You can toggle between the views on the upper right corner of your screen. If you click on Gallery View, you will see a mosaic of all people taking part on the call. If you click on Speaker View, the person who is speaking will always appear on center screen. That's it for managing your Zoom call. See you on the next video.